What's up, everybody out there in quarantine land? This is your host of the One Stone Dude podcast, Ryan Castle, and I'm talking to you about the Anchor app today. That's what this podcast is coming to you from. There are so many advantages to this app, it's hard to explain, but if you haven't heard about the Anchor app, it's the easiest way to make a podcast, so let me explain real quick. It's free. Then you have your creation tools that allow you to record and edit your podcast right from your phone or your computer. Anchor will then distribute your podcast for you so it can be heard on Spotify, Apple Podcasts, and many more. You can make money from your podcast with no minimum listenership. It's everything you need to make a podcast all in one place. So go to the Anchor app or go to anchor.fm to get started and keep your First Amendment rights going. Welcome back to the One Stone Dude podcast. This is your host, Ryan Castle. Real quick, I just want to give a shout out to people that live in Ireland that are listening to this show. People in Spain. Yeah, I went international. Ain't that some shit? People in Ireland, drink a pint for me. Feel free to email me or to Facebook me. You can email me at autobot0311@protonmail.com. Or you can Facebook me at Ryan Castle. I'd love to hear from some international listeners. Real quick, I want to talk about my audience, and then we'll go into the interview with Dex from Hardway University. I noticed my age group is 45 to 33. That's my listening audience. I cannot express how much I appreciate you guys supporting me. I guess we're vibing. I guess we're on the same wavelength. And it's a shame that nobody else is. You may or may not agree with my position on politics, but hell, man, I'm not going to argue with anybody about it. It's just my political views, and I'm on a podcast, so I feel I have the right to say what I feel when it comes to my political views, but whatever, I'll get rid of that. But I want to get back to this age group thing. You see the people that come before us, like the 50-plus age group, they are fucking up. They are fucking up bad. And a lot of us are fucked up because of them. A lot of them are irresponsible parents. They have the largest number of child molesters in any age group ever. It's mind-blowing sometimes. You know, I think, and they kind of look at us like, oh, you don't know what you're talking about, kid, even if you're like 40 or 44. They're like, oh, you don't know what you're talking about, kid. We know what, yeah, no, you don't. Old people get swindled and robbed all the time. And then they get on the news and are like, oh, this is a Joe Rogan thing. I'm sorry. This is Doug Stanhope's bit. So this is what I heard from him. He said, older people get phone calls and then send money to a Nigerian prince, and they get fucking ripped off left and right, but they know better. And they're smarter than us. Well, when you get to a certain age, your brain starts to go. So, you know, no offense to anybody listening that's in that age group, but no, you're not. You're not. Your age group's fucking this country up. Hasn't been fucking this country up for the last 20 years. And you haven't been good at anything. Nobody in your age group has invented shit. So next time somebody younger than you tries to speak their mind, pipe down. Be open-minded. Sit the fuck back and listen. You might learn something. Now, we could always learn something from our elders, but keep in mind what they tell you. And consider the source of information. What kind of person is this person that's telling you something? You know, are they a shitbag or are they an outstanding citizen? You know, that's up to you to decide. But I know just because some older person gives me advice doesn't mean I'm going to take it. Because that person could be all types of fucked up. And has made many mistakes, and they learned from, well, maybe they're still making the same mistakes because they're in the position they're in. So that's my rant for now. Anyway, back to Dex. Dextor, was the first person I wrestled in Destiny Wrestling Organization, which is a company that's no longer around right now due to the Athletic Commission of New Mexico, which I don't understand because wrestling is not an athletic competition. It is a, it's like a play. So you'd have to charge people who do plays the same amount that you charge people to do wrestling. And if they're not, well, that's just shitty. And if anybody's listening that's on the board of the New Mexico Sports Commission, whatever the fuck you call it, you're a dick. Because you shut down a good company. They had something good going. And it's a shitty thing to have happen. And if anybody cares, write them. Write the Sports Commission in New Mexico and tell them how, you know, how shitty of a job they did. Anyhow, Dex is a trainer. I believe he's the head trainer of Hardway U. He was a hardcore match type of wrestler. And I'll be interviewing him today and asking him probably the same questions that I asked Josh Payne. They were part of a group called DRC, and now they run the school Hardway U. It should be an interesting interview. Dex is always a character, not as much as Josh, but pretty much the same. So it should be interesting, and I'm looking forward to it. So I hope you guys enjoy. And I got a Rodney Dangerfield clip I want to share with you guys. He was on Jonny Carsson in 1974, and he's the king of the one-liners. So I hope you guys enjoy that. Have a great day. Oh, I'm sorry. Enjoy your weekend. Oh, also, you can check out my merch at snaptea.co under Rides for You. And if you want an unedited, unpublished copy of my book, Rides for You, email me once again at autobot0311@protonmail.com. And I'll, or Facebook me at Ryan Castle. Give me your email, leave your email, and I'll send you a copy. And I guarantee you'll enjoy it. Everybody that's read it has told me good things about it, so I'm hoping to get it out a little more. All right, and we'll go to the next clip. Thanks for listening.
What a crowd, what a crowd. You know, beautiful, beautiful. They're good. They're great out there. Thank you very much. And I tell you, tonight it's nice. We've got a grown-up crowd, too, you know. Yeah, I did a show last week for a bunch of teenagers. And these kids carry on today. You can't tell boys from girls. I mean, the girls that wear slacks, fellas let their hair grow. I was talking to someone here. I said, look at that teenager. Was that a boy or a girl? He said, that's a boy. That's my son. I said, sure, you knew you're his father. He said, I'm not his father. I'm his mother. I don't know. I tell you, life isn't easy. After a while, I don't know who to believe anymore. Well, the other day, I was in my bank. They got signs all over there. At this bank of a friend. Last month, I was two payments behind. My friend took away my car. I tell you, with me, nothing comes easy. Nothing, you know? Well, last week, I saw my dentist. Not a beauty, my dentist. I said to him, can you put in a new tooth to match my other teeth? He put in a tooth with four cavities. And I'll tell you, last week was a rough week for me, you know, last week. I broke up my psychiatrist, too, last week. For the first time, I told him I got suicidal tendencies. He told me from now on I have to pay in advance. Well, the first time I saw a psychiatrist, I felt like 2 cents. I was a kid. I said to him, Doc, can you help me? All day long, he's thinking I'm ugly. He made me lay on a couch, face down. I tell you, when I was a kid, I got no respect. No respect at all, you know? The time I was lost on a beach, and a cop had me look for my parents. I said to the cop, I think we'll find them. He said, I don't know, kid, there's so many places I could hide. When I was a kid, my old man, he didn't help either, you know. The time I asked my old man if I can go ice skating on a lake, he told me to wait till it gets warmer. I tell you, sometimes I can't take it no more. Well, today I got 2 kids, and that's rough, too, you know. You can't talk to kids today. My boy's birthday last week, had a little party, brought out the cake. The kid blew out all the candles. I said to him, hope your wish comes true. He said, if it does, that's the last time you'll watch me blow out candles. Smart kid I got, you know.
Like the last time I took my kid to Coney Island, I asked him if he wanted to go in a crazy house. He told me to save my money. He'll be home soon. Here we are out with a couple of blondes.
Yeah. Hey, it's good to see you again. It's been a long time.
I always get a kick out of coming out here. They treat you right over here. There's one place they treat you right. You know, I leave the club. I close this week at a club in New York. But I'll be back next Monday.
You just close September 9th. Lock it up completely?
I lock the whole thing up for a week. Now I'll come back next Monday night, September 9th, and tell my jokes are going to Dangerfield. But it's always a kick to come out here.
Yeah.
I love it out here, you know. I like to go to Vegas, too, you know.
Do you?
I'm going to Vegas right, for a couple of days. I always go over there. You meet so many wonderful, wonderful people in Vegas,
uh-huh.
Johnny. No idea.
Can you tell us about a few of them?
Well, last time I was there, I met a lovely girl.
Uh-huh.
Oh, a lovely girl. Valerie Dubois.
Valerie Dubois.
Oh, a lovely girl. Valerie Dubois. In fact, she told me to call her VD for sure.
He didn't. Valerie Dubois.
Wonderful people out in Vegas.
Yeah,
nice, but oh, Vegas really swings. They got the gambling there, the
wild.
Big hotels and nightclubs. Oh, that's what big nightclubs they got there.
Yeah.
So it isn't really so different than the places I worked when I broke in. You know, the tough places.
You work in a little joint,
oh,
right?
Oh, I work tough place. You know, places like Rosario's Rocket Room. You know.
Rosario's Rocket Room. Tough.
Dominic's Atomic Bar and Grill. Oh, he's another one. Sure. Oh, Dominic, he was tough. Ooh,
yeah.
Was he tough, Dominic?
Tough owner.
During the show, he used to yell at the acts all the time.
Yeah.
One night a guy was singing, "Why was I born?" He yelled out, "Not to sing!" You know.
That's a real heckler, Dominic. Oh, yeah. Bad news, yeah.
I'll tell you, show business, you got to get the breaks. You got to get the breaks, Johnny.
I would guess so, yeah.
I never got the breaks, never.
Really?
As a kid, I never got the breaks either, never.
This has been following you all your life, you mean?
I was rough when I was a kid.
Yeah.
I was a kid the first time I had my picture taken. The pony threw me. Another one I should have
You
got
to try him out of town, right. You can't bring him in.
Take him on a road to you. Take him on a road. You got to break him in. So you ever get the feeling you wasted your whole life?
Uh-huh.
I don't know. It's not easy. I got no respect the day I was born.
Really?
No respect. The doctor picked me up and smacked me. I found out the nurse, she got a few in, too. You know?
We got to take a break here, but
then
we'll come right back and find out how your health is, because I'm always interested.
This just comes out so much, I feel like I'm doing a magic act up here.
Well, after this message of interest.
Strangles himself, I'm waiting for hell, like hell, shit, I'm anxious as hell. Manson, you're safe in that cell, be thankful it's jail. I used to be my mommy's little angel at 12, 13, I was putting shells in a gauge on the shelf. I used to get punked and bullied on my block, till I cut a kitten's head off and stuck it in his kid's mailbox. I used to give a fuck, now I can give a fuck less. What do I think of success? It sucks. Too much press and stress, too much stress, depressed. Too upset, it's just too much mess. I guess I must just blew up quick.
Yes,
grew up quick.
No.
Was raised right. Whatever you say's wrong. Whatever I say's right. You think of my name now whenever you say hi. Became a commodity cause I'm W-H-I-T-E. Cause
train wreck commences, my friend.
Well, we caught the first couple seconds of that. Welcome back to the One Stone Dude podcast. I am your host, Ryan Castle. Today with me on the line is a very good friend of mine. He is a former professional wrestler turned trainer for Hardway University in Albuquerque, New Mexico. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome Dextor. We're going to start.
Josh,
Dextor, how
man.
You doing? Hey, how you doing?
Good, brother. I'm hanging in there, man. Long time no talkie.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. It's the actual first conversation that me and Dextor have in like, what, 5, 6 years, 7 years, something like that?
I think directly on the phone, that sounds really close. You know, obviously little snippets back and forth, but you know, this will be fun. We'll get to catch up together, and then the whole world will get to hear it, brother.
Right? No shit. You know, I just like to look out for people that looked out for me, and you gave me my first match in Destiny Wrestling. I started to become a regular for a little while, and I wanted to thank you personally for that. It means a lot, and you put me over like a champ, and it was an awesome match from what I remember. So, thank you very much.
Yeah, no, I mean, man, it was nice. Obviously, just meeting kind of some of the younger talent. I mean, don't get me wrong, I was young as well, and I mean, the match itself, it probably lives better in our minds, good versus if we actually looked at it and we're like, oh, that's the drizzling shits. But you know, if we never have to see it, know, it was a fucking five star because, you know, we feel like it was, and that's all that matters.